Hello, I'm Krasita Siwam Sigiri, astrologer, and this is my lunar forecast for the lunar month of 15th of June until the 15th, approximately the 15th of July. So this is the lunar month, and during this lunar month, we are following the path of the moon, starting from the first thin lunar crescent on the evening of the 15th of June until the first lunar crescent on the 14th of July. So we are following up astronomically the path of the moon, and anything she's meeting on her path, like stars and planets and constellations, is creating events which manifest on our reality. So this is about what the spiritual sidereal astrology is. It is about showing the astronomical, the real sky. Now what we have is that this lunar month is in antiquity was in ancient Babylon was the moon Siman, and this lunar month was ruled by Nana or Sin in the ancient Sumer, and this was the lunar god who is ruling the month. It's very important to say who is ruling, which divinity is ruling the months, because this way we know what is what is the dominance of the month. And we say this is wisdom, this is intuition, since this is what we relate the lunar god to. So the first lunar crescent, which marks the beginning of the month, will be visible in the last degrees of Gemini. This makes the moon first conjoint with the Martian star Pollux. This is one of the twins, one of the Gemini twins. And this is how the month will be looking like. The moon, the month will be Martian. Could be that we hear about violences. The financial markets will be important. And knowing the position of Mars conjoint Ketu, we know that the financial markets cannot have any prosperity. And then the moon is void of course. So void of course moon is not positive for the month, not productive. She cannot bring any significant positive results. This is about the start of the month. Then the next two lunar days, 16th, and I'm turning the sky to look, 16th and the 17th of June, the moon is first conjoint with Venus, receiving opposition from Mars, and this we will feel in terms of financial markets, and I don't think this will be very positive indeed, knowing that Mars is still conjoint with the lunar node. And I spoke about this actually in my previous prognosis. On the 17th of June, the moon is void of course. This is a day where nothing can be really reached. This is a day when we cannot do any new initiatives, no surgical interventions. We can do our routine work and hope for good result. On the 18th of June, which is the fourth lunar month, this is important lunar month, which could be good for new beginnings, but once again, watch out, because Mars is aiming in stationary phase, Saturn is retrograde. So in general, financially, the situation is not good, but if you really need a day for starting new beginning, this is the day. And this is the 18th, probably also 19th of June. No surgical interventions, however. The day will be good for those who practice esoterics and astrological knowledges and sciences. 20th, 21st, the moon is in Virgo. It's a square with the sun, so the ruler of Virgo is afflicted, so we cannot really expect super outcomes from our activities, but we can certainly be very productive in terms of oratory activities, writing, acting, teaching, astrology, gaining any knowledge. So we will, mathematics, grammar. So we will be good in teaching, in studying. But in terms of results, I'm not sure how productive they can be. The day is fine to travel, not fine for surgical interventions. And this is 2021. 22, 23, the moon will be with Jupiter. This is very, again, a positive day in terms of if you really need to start something, not perfect, but you may benefit from 22 and 23 of June. These two days will be good for beauty, harmony, acting, because the moon is passing through important stars which are related to particularly to this. Certainly no surgical interventions, but yes, for productive activities in relation to beauty or creating, acting, performing. Also design as well. So this is 23rd as well. 24th, the moon is in Scorpio. 24, 25, and 26. These 3 days are not really appropriate for new beginnings. They are not appropriate for surgical interventions. They will be good for those of you who do healing, who would do spiritual practices, meditation, enhancing intuition, dealing especially with those most secretive sciences and knowledges of the esoterics. Once again, no new beginnings, no surgical things. And this is until the 26th of June. 27, 28, the moon will be conjoined with Saturn, who is in a phase of cosmic setting. Then he's really not very good, powerful, and quite destructive. So those of you who have astronomical sidereal, Sagittarius, better note that this might have certain impact on your moods. You might have some obstacles in what you do, but this is only temporary until the moon is leaving, and this is happening on the 29th of June. But still keep in mind that sidereally Saturn is of course still in a difficult heliacal phase in sidereal Sagittarius and in tropical Capricorn. So if you have really not very beneficial period, note that this is due to Saturn, and one day certainly this will of course pass. The moon is entering on the 29th of June, Capricorn. Here, she is meeting Mars, who is about to be stationary. And then she's meeting also Ketu, the lunar node. This can have impact on financial markets, which we spoke about a lot last time. These 2 days, 29 and 3rd, are not good to travel. No surgical interventions, no new initiatives for sure. The 2 days before, 27 and 28, I forgot to mention that there was a full moon. And during this full moon, if you experience extreme emotions, note that this is due to the full moon and this will pass. During this moment, you might need to reconsider your moral values. You need to spend time contemplating, also really meditating and do spiritual awakening practices for yourself. Now, 1st of July, the moon is still in Capricorn, the last degrees. Unafflicted but still conjoined Mars, so I wouldn't do any risks. Still no surgical interventions, unfortunately. And then the 2nd of July and the 3rd of July, the moon is passing through the beautiful, especially on the 2nd of July, the beautiful degrees of Aquarius, where she will be meeting Fomalhaut, the fixed star of the spiritual priest. These are beautiful degrees of really white, a beautiful spirituality, where you might feel tempted to do spiritual work or to share your knowledge with the others. And you might also have good results. This is a day possible for surgical interventions, but certainly not good for new beginnings. This is valid also for the 2nd and the 3rd of July. And then you have the 4th of July, the moon is entering Pisces. She will be afflicted by Saturn, but still, good time to do your routine work with high moral standards, moral values. You might like to share your knowledge with the others, to teach them, to help them enhance their in your own intuition. And this is happening on the 4th, 5th, and 6th of July until the moon will be in Pisces. Now, I wouldn't advise surgical interventions because the moon is afflicted here. Especially on the 6th of July, she will have no course. So, it's better that we do routine business, but nothing new indeed, because these are not productive days when the moon is void of course. But still, we might be very happy in terms of spiritual awareness. We might experience powerful intuition. This is always the case until the moon is passing, especially from the 20th to the 30th degrees are very powerful spiritual degrees in the Pisces. 7th of July, the moon is conjoining Uranus and receiving a harmful aspect from Mars. Here, not good to travel, no surgical interventions, no conflicts, try to avoid. We might be tempted to feel ambitious in our work. So, in this case, it's good to do our routine work with caution. And this is also on the 8th of July. Then, 9th and 10th of July are quite powerful days because the moon is passing through Taurus, where she's exalted, very pleased, passing a day of Debaran, star of money and wealth. Good for routine business, good for generating money, not good for new beginnings, because this is the last crescent. So, only this day, 9th we see the moon, and then she's, 10th of July we see the moon, then she's disappearing in the rays of the sun, where on the 11th, 12th, and the 13th of July, she will be 3 days invisible. Until the moon is invisible, the mythology says that the lunar god descends to the netherworld, the underworld, to solve the destinies of the dead. So this is not the time to do anything that you would expect to be productive. It's wonderful time to do spiritual work. It's wonderful time to enhance your intuition, to contemplate, to meditate, to work on your intuition, to do esoteric studies. Wonderful. You might have good results. Not good to travel. Absolutely not good for surgical interventions. Try really to do as less as possible in terms of active activities, business, and to do as much as possible in terms of spirituality. And all this until the 14th of July, where we will see the first lunar crescent happening in Cancer. Before that, the moon will be also in the nebula of Cancer, where this is harmful. Therefore, I'm saying, do your spiritual activities, connect with the moon, but really do not undertake any active business. So, this was my brief description of how the lunar month, how the lunarium from the 15th of June till the 14th of July will look like. I hope this was useful, and you can see my next prognosis next month. Until then, you may contact me through my website www.crassyancientastrology.com. Thank you.